How about letting her work in the garden with me?
Is that where you want to be buried?
I'll be buried there if the others get to me sooner.
Well, it's not that dark.
I have the job of keeping Bella Albrecht alive and unscathed. All this will go in my report to the department. Now, will you kindly remove yourself and your effects out of here?
You leave her alone.
Oh, rat off, fatso. Leave her alone. Get off me.
I hope you rot in hell.
You can look after yourself, then.
Oh, well, if I can't do better than the village idiot. Anyway, they're keeping all the women away from me now, so I don't need you.
Hello there and welcome to the video. My name's SerenitySoloREACTS and here we are with Prisoner Cell Block H episode 52. This will be the last I record before my, not completely, don't worry, before I go into a big bunch of editing. So hopefully it doesn't catch up too much to this. You're on episode 30 as of recording this, I'm on episode 52. That leaves me 22 episodes and then I'm going to lose like 16, 17, maybe 18 episodes. That leaves me 4 in front. Wow. It's going to take me like 2 months to edit. But yes, I am enjoying this. I don't think Bella's dead. I could be wrong, could be totally wrong. I was wrong with being in solitary. But yeah, I don't think she's dead, but I think she might be hurt. It must have been Martha, because she wants to be accepted by the girls by the looks of it now. So maybe she will do something to try to be accepted. I do think Dr. Clements will tell the truth about him telling them. I think Cannon will get her parole. Must be close now, must be very close. Lynn seems to be staying out of it, thank God, but no Lynn came back, so why not Lynn? But anyway, I am enjoying it and I hope you are too. And if you have subscribed to me so far, thank you ever so much, I really do appreciate it. You're helping me out, you're helping the channel out, you're helping my mental health out, you honestly are. And if you're one of my Patreon members, you'll get exclusive shows, which will be on the screen right now. 8 per month right now, going up to 12 per month quite soon. The third day is already being worked on to make it 12 per month, and that'll be X-Files, American Horror Story, Roseanne and Cheers. And then there'll be a fourth day later this year or early next year, which will be a complete drama day. And that will be stuff like Dynasty, Dallas, Footballers' Wives, Band of Gold, Quantum Leap, stuff like that. I know Quantum Leap's more sci-fi, but drama. It's got drama in it, so I'm putting that there. And also ad-free and uncensored early access as well to all my shows. So no bleeps, no blurs, nothing like that. Because it is you that is bringing the content to me to allow me to bring the content straight back to you. Thank you all ever so much. I love you lots no matter what tier you are. So with that, let's get on with the episode.
Have they been saying anything about me?
Who?
The prisoners.
I still don't think she's dead.
They don't have me in their confidence. Come on.
Reception.
Pleasant memories. Through there. Now get a move on.
So I'm guessing that all the shower blocks are in reception, even though it looks exactly the same as the shower blocks they use. Where the hell did she hide? I mean, she must have seen her when she walked in. Kevin looks a lot older than her mugshot, doesn't she? Bloody hell.
That's enough of that, Eves.
What did I do?
You attacked her, didn't you?
Oh, I did not.
Well, she yelled loud enough.
If you're trying to offer protection.
You scared the living daylights out of me. I just wanted to be friendly-like.
That's why you snuck up on me.
I wanted to talk without them listening.
Oh, a private conference, eh? What's all this about?
Nothing. Did B. Smith send you?
What did she say? She wants to give her protection.
B. Smith. She thinks I'm stupid.
Oh, whereas you're really an intellectual giant. Now get out of here. Go on. Well, Albrecht, you finally found yourself a friend.
Is she setting him up, though? She's, like, kind of running him into a false sense of security and then she's going to kill her?
What do you want?
I want to see her.
You've already frightened her enough already.
We're going to be mates.
Oh, come off it, Eves. B. Smith told you to put the fear of death into her, didn't she?
I'm not talking to B. Smith.
No, but you're listening.
I'm sure that she never used to be this dumb.
Now get on your way.
It's not like me saying it behind her back. You said it to her face like that.
Bloody
hell.
Of your fan club.
Who?
Martha Reeves. She's all right. You think so, do you? Well, it's your life. It's the others I've got to worry about. How about letting her work in the garden with me?
Is that where you want to be buried?
I'll be buried there if the others get to me sooner. Look, you can't guard me all the time. Why don't you let her do it?
Why would she want to?
Because she thinks I'm the only one who doesn't think she's stupid.
She is stupid.
So what? So maybe she's the ultimate moron. Who's worried? Not me. Not when she's the only thing that stands between me and the heavies you've got round
can't
here.
Can't she stop, like, 15 women? Well, she need more
morning.
Of a body, more bodyguards than that.
Money. I almost expect you to ask me if I've got a clean.
I feel like an hour.
The prisoner won't be going out today. What do you think you're up to?
But I thought it was all right.
Your study release is at the governor's pleasure. Now, Mrs. Davidson hasn't rescinded her orders.
Oh, but Bea told her. Now she knows I wasn't the one that broke my word about Bella Albrecht.
Well, she said nothing about you being released for university. Not today.
But Bea said...
Look, Travers, whatever you might think, Bea Smith doesn't run this place. Now, Mrs. Davidson hasn't changed her mind. Well, not yet anyway.
Didn't she believe me?
You know, she prefers to have all the facts in front of her before she makes a decision.
Well,
right.
She'll probably ask me to
get it with her.
Well, do you think if he's the one that spilt the beans, he'll own up to it, huh?
He might not.
Afraid of looking stupid. Some psychologist telling the women in here that a prisoner had killed her 5-year-old kitty.
He wouldn't care what people thought of him. What would really worry him would be to be thrown out of here before he'd finished his work.
I thought he had finished. He stopped interviewing the prisoners.
It's not really what his thesis was all about.
Isn't it?
The officers.
Then what's so important that he'd throw you to the wolves rather than risk getting chucked out of here?
What are you doing here?
I'm waiting to see the doctor.
What's wrong with you?
I don't have to tell you.
Huh. Faking it, I suppose. That's just what we need here. One more hypochondriac.
I'm sick. I was sick this morning. I'm sick every morning. I've got to see the doctor.
Well, don't hold your breath. He won't be in today.
Why? What's wrong with him?
Nothing. He's just working in his own practice. Now get back to your cell.
Are we going to see him in his own practice?
Of course you want to sit here all day.
Oh.
Yes, we are.
Oh, gowns here. Laundry goes out every week. Tuesdays. Miss Gibb will look after that when she comes back.
Can you really afford to keep a cleaning on, though?
You'll find some old favourites there.
Good Lord. This is the 1912 edition.
So am I, young man.
Bit
so
dated,
am I.
Mate.
I've been practising here since the war. This is how I spent my deferred pay. Old McElraith ran it then. Robbed me blind.
I don't think I know him.
Barely a man alive does. He's been dead for 30 years. Good surgeon, though. Well, I haven't much time. Have you any questions?
No, I don't think so, not at the moment.
Good, good. Now, you've got the numbers of Collins Street and East Melbourne.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I hope you won't be disappointed with our bargain. If you are, you won't have much time to brood on it.
Oh, I'll manage.
I suspect
don't
you
have
will.
To keep on top of
well,
medical advancements?
What you expect in this sort of area. A stream of kids with measles, whooping cough, mumps, and blind ignorance. Pregnant women, aged 15 to 50. Lots of workers' comp. As a ray of sunshine in your day, the occasional stab and bash victim.
Well, sounds more invigorating than my last billet. All I had there was a queue of women after Valium and a chance to be alone with the doc.
You'll get it here. I get it, my God, and I'm 67. What's the matter with women these days? Or do you think it's the men? Fresh air and exercise, I tell them. That'll fix them up, take their minds
it's
off
definitely
sex.
Old school.
Well, I must run along. I'll drop in and see you again tonight. Good luck.
Thank you.
Yeah, I diagnosed...
Oh, and by the way, don't take that down. You won't get a cent out of them unless you ring it up. They're all rogues here, all on the take.
Yes, I diagnosed you with cancer. A bit of fresh air will clear it up. Yeah, whatever. Is he going to regret leaving the prison? Guess that smile's not going to last long. Oh. I wondered who it were. It's Peter.
Lovely morning. G'day, Jim. Great day, isn't it?
The governor would like to see you in her office straight away.
All in good time.
She said she wanted you as soon as you arrived.
She wants me? Well, I'm happy to oblige. But 9 in the AM's a bit brutal. I'm at my best when the lights are low.
Yes, I'll tell her I gave you the message at exactly 9:35.
I'm going. I trust I know my duty.
Eves and Albrecht? That's an unlikely partnership. And Albrecht wants her as a watchdog.
That seems to be the idea.
Well, what makes her think that Martha can be trusted?
I don't know, really, but she was quite adamant that she could handle Eves. Albrecht has meant an increased workload for all of us. But even so, it's impossible to have her guarded every second of the day.
Yes, I can see what a help Eve's cooperation would be, but... Well, it's such an unlikely partnership.
I'd call Eves in and give her a chat.
I'd like to be sure she's not getting close to her for reasons of her own.
She hasn't the brains for it, and she's not smart enough for the others to use her either.
Very well. We'll let her work with Albrecht. But keep an eye on them, to where sure... that things are what they seem.
Give me a chance, and if anything happens to her, it's her responsibility.
At your service, Governor. You wanted me?
Yes, Dr. Clements, I had a few things I wanted to discuss with you.
Oh, my pleasure.
I don't think we need detain you any further, Miss Bennett.
Well, what on earth have I done to warrant such an icy blue stare?
Peter, I thought you understood that the women here regard infanticide as the cardinal sin, and that it was vital that Bella Albrecht's offence should not be made known to them.
That's an interesting moment.
Erica, talk about shutting the stable door. I mean, everyone knew already. It's common knowledge.
It was not common knowledge until your interview with B. Smith.
Oh, rubbish. B came in full of it. Otherwise, I wouldn't have said a word.
What exactly did she say?
Well, if I remember correctly, she pointed out that it was rather ridiculous of you to expect them to believe that Bella was in for your common or garden murder, when you'd authorised such extraordinary security precautions.
She was probing for information and she succeeded. It's the oldest trick in the book, to pretend you know something when you don't.
B must have a higher IQ than I thought.
Well, you've got a lower one.
It never crossed my mind for a minute that I was being manipulated.
No, it wouldn't. It's usually the other way round. You're very good at manipulating people.
Well, is he fired now?
Them's unkind words, Governess.
Ever since you have been allowed access to this prison, you have abused your privilege of working here. You even pushed one girl into a complete breakdown.
Doreen.
And you may yet cause the death of another.
Oh, nonsense, Erica.
It is not nonsense. I had the job of keeping Bella Albrecht alive and unscathed. All this will go in my report to the department. Now, will you kindly remove yourself and your effects out of here?
Right now? I thought you liked having me around.
I thought your presence here would serve some useful purpose. I even thought your thesis would be of some value. But having observed both you and your methods, Dr. Clements, I doubt very much whether you could produce anything of value.
Well, I may yet surprise you. I wasn't entirely concentrating on criminal psychology, you know. I was angling in this little waterhole for something a lot bigger.
Yes, you would be here under false pretenses.
Well, everything's fair in love and psychology. Come publication, I think you'll find my little thesis very good reading. I'll even send you an autographed copy.
I suspect it's going to write something that's going to make them look really bad.
And these are little roses.
Cecil Brunner. They're called Cecil Brunner.
Treat her nice.
I thought they was roses.
They're dwarf roses.
What's on about dwarfs for?
Oh, look, would you rather I went on about garden gnomes?
What gnomes?
Okay, I'm not very fond of gnomes myself.
They're roses. I know they're roses. We had roses on our lino, would I?
I wouldn't be at all surprised.
Huh?
We used to have roses around the tennis court. I had a Shetland pony who loved them. We had a lot of trouble trying to keep him away.
A pony? Where'd you keep a pony?
In the she's fish acting pond. Dumb. She's
Where
not
the hell
this
do you
dumb.
Think
I know she's.
Kept the pony?
I know she's not polite, but it's not like this.
I don't like you talking like that.
All right, look, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
As if I was stupid or something.
Okay. This needs pruning. Are there any secateurs? Hmm? Oh, you know.
Ah, those. We wouldn't be allowed to have those.
Why not?
Someone would have a go at you. You'd have a go.
Oh, my God. Why did they have to put me in with these people?
Well, you killed your kid, didn't you?
I wasn't to blame for that. I don't see how anyone could hold me responsible. I should never have had that baby.
No,
I was only a child.
That's not an excuse.
Just think, Martha. Pregnant on my 18th birthday.
That's nothing. Me mum had me on her 14th.
Well, explains a lot.
Mr. Clements, I've come to make you an offer.
Sorry, Lizzie, I don't think you've got anything I want.
Well, I wouldn't be too sure. You're interested in cold-blooded killers, aren't you?
Have you got one on tap?
Me? I'm the biggie. I bumped off 4 huge men. 4 big bastards in the primes of their life.
From what I heard, that was more of an accident.
Got me 20 years, didn't it?
Oh, that.
You want me to tell you about it?
I did think she was in for life of that pillow.
Save it for your memoirs. For them.
Oh, it'll only cost you a packet of fags and maybe a few bickies.
Oh, I'm not doing any more interviews. The governor thinks I have been a naughty boy.
Coming on too free with the girls, eh?
Fair go. That would be what your dirty old mind would conjure up.
Well, what else?
Bea conned me into letting her know about Bella Albrecht. I must say, I underestimated Bea.
Yeah.
Oh, was he conned?
To keep that dark. But you got Buckley's chance of doing that in here.
Anyway, the governor has given me the big A. She wasn't happy about that. And a few other things.
Poor door, eh?
Yes, I guess I miscalculated there. No hard feelings, huh, Lizzie?
Well, she wasn't the full 2 bob, was she, poor old Dor?
I took the old packet.
But she was soft-hearted. Slow as a week in Wentworth. Sure you don't want to give me them bickies? Oh, you're a good sort. Well, Haru...
Could that be classed as contraband?
Now, I'm sure I'm speaking for the other girls as well as myself about Doreen when I say, I hope you rot in hell! Hello, love. Why aren't you Junie?
I'm going to barracks, Lizzie. Where'd you get the loot?
From Clements. He's quite generous when you know how to handle him.
I'm glad someone thinks so. He's the reason I'm still in here.
What'd he do?
That's what he hasn't
done. Why's he not been called?
He hasn't told Mrs. Davidson that he was the one that blew the whistle on Bella Albrecht.
She has.
She's blaming me. Oh, Lizzie, I'm so sick of being let out of here like a dog on a chain and then reeled back in again.
Oh. Never mind, love. Have a jockey, Bicky.
No, thanks. Coming from him, I'd probably choke. If she's going to believe him, you know, she won't believe me. It's going to be my word against a professor of psychology.
You know how I got the bickies?
Probably conned him.
Yeah, I did a bit of that. But he was cleaning out his drawer. Yep, he got it with a chicken got the axe.
That means it's going to be a tutor again, though.
She knows. Oh, Lizzie, that's terrific.
I don't know why you're so keen on getting out of here. You're all right here. You got your friends, you got your regular meals.
I thought Doreen was saying to Lynn.
I wouldn't give you tuppence to get out of here.
Lizzie, you don't want to die in here like Edie.
I don't want to die out there.
But there are things outside you've never seen before. You'd have the time of your life.
There are things out there I don't want to see. I'm all right in here. And I'm going to see to it that I stay here.
You can't make them keep
so
you.
So we forgot Lizzie for the duration, then?
I can do things that'll keep me here for the rest of my days. I can do things so bad they'll be scared to put me out.
Bella? See, it's doing what Soap did. It's setting up all these suspects now.
Call me a cab, there's a good girl.
Leaving us, Dr. Clements.
Moving on. I'll miss you, Vera. I've always been strangely drawn to you. All that repressed sexuality waiting to be tapped. My God, you're a challenge.
I beg your pardon.
Why don't we get together and explore each other properly? Or even improperly? Your place, Friday?
Certainly not. Who do you think you are?
Well, who do you think you are, turning down an offer like that? Do you think you can afford to be choosy? Ah, here comes the military man. Well, you'll be heartbroken to know I'm leaving, Jim. Mrs. Davidson not cooperative.
Is he just going to put everyone's noses out of joint?
Well, you can't expect prison officers to be as other women. It's the life. A 40% chance of normalcy at best.
Well, I don't know how we're going to struggle on without you.
Well, I wouldn't advise you to struggle much further with your little problem.
I haven't got any problems.
Jim, the man who says he has no problems, has he got problems? Still, psychiatric science can do marvels these days. You can get something done about your hemophobia.
What the hell are you talking about?
Don't worry about it. Your little secret's safe with me. Tell him I'll be waiting outside the gates.
But now Vera knows.
I don't know what the record is, Lizzie, but I reckon you must be the fastest tooth in the West. Where'd you get him?
From the town psychologist.
Yeah? How's he off the fags?
He's gone. Chucked out.
You beaut. After what you did to Doreen, he couldn't leave fast enough for me. Not that he didn't have his uses.
You were too smart for him, weren't you, B? He couldn't keep anything from you.
He might have meant to do it, though.
Psychologist.
Got towards the end of his thesis. You want to cause trouble?
Here comes the baby killer.
Yeah.
Well, it was five.
And the big M.
Maybe toddler killer?
She looks bigger every time I look at her. You need a pickaxe to get her behind her.
Reckon I can't do it, eh?
Well, when are you going to make a move? That Albrecht woman will think she's got the better of you.
Let her, that's good.
Keep. Gone. You're chickening.
Say that again, Lizzie, and I'll give those teeth of yours a well-earned rest. I'm going to use a bit of science, see? Everyone's waiting for me to get that bitch. The cons are waiting, the screws are waiting, and she's waiting. And that's just the way I like it.
Wouldn't hurt to bash a one.
It wouldn't hurt you. The governor's woken up to me. One wrong move and she sends me to a tougher prison, which means I'd have to work my way to the top all over again. And geez, I don't think I'm that young anymore. No, we'll just keep Bella baby on the hop for a while.
I'll be in on that. Watch this.
Is someone else going to come in who does it for them?
Hello, love. You must have got real hungry working out in the garden. Nothing like fresh air to give you a good appetite.
What do you want?
Nothing. I just had a windfall. Thought I'd like to share it. Have a bicky.
I've been thinking what you've done to them.
Dinner won't be long.
Great. I'm hungry enough even to eat that swill.
Yeah, not too good, is it? Now, I used to be a cook in civilian life. That's why they let me help out around here sometimes.
What are you in for?
Murder. I'm a dab hand at poisons. No need to worry, they've always got Martha to taste it first.
I'm gonna say Martha Lewis. I'd like to eat it first when I said it.
Hello. Hi, how's uni going?
All right, I guess.
Can I come in? Aren't you enjoying your psych course?
I don't mind the work. I enjoy it. It's just that now that I'm leaving Wentworth, I wonder whether or not I've picked myself a blind alley. After I'm qualified, what? If you're as crash hot as I've heard, why don't you apply for a postgraduate grant?
I don't want to hang around the uni. Too many people like Peter Clements. They're a bit disillusioning.
I didn't want to go to uni either. But my dad pushed me into it. Part of a campaign to impress my stepmother.
Problem is, she's got to see Peter now.
Been far better
it's
off
going to be tutoring
job.
Her again.
I wouldn't have met Tom Burton for one thing.
He had quite a reputation around the campus, didn't you know?
I suppose I'm not the first he got pregnant.
You sure you're going to have a baby?
I've got morning sickness to prove it. Bloody men. Oh, they love you. They adore you. They just can't live without you. But watch them head for the hills when a little accident occurs.
It's not a little accident, Melinda. It's a real baby. Something of your own. In a way, I envy you. You won't have to worry about what you're going to do with the rest of your life.
Were you ever pregnant? Well, at least mine won't be born in jail. My solicitor thinks I'll get away with probation.
When's your trial?
Monday. And that's why I've got to get to see Greg Miller. And soon. I need a medical report to prove I'm pregnant. Has he gone for good, do you know?
I don't think she'll get bail.
He's got a few days to finish up.
Now, if this were his baby, it'd be worth the trouble.
Get off.
I reckon he's the sexiest thing I've seen in a white coat since Ben Casey. He'd do me for a quickie on the old examination couch. Don't you like him? I thought you were old mates.
He's all right.
Only all right? You sure we're talking about the same man?
We should be. I used to be engaged to him.
Oh, hello, Doctor. How's the new practice?
Busy enough.
Oh, someone came to see you yesterday. Melinda Cross.
Nothing urgent.
Oh, nothing that you and I would consider urgent. But she seemed to think it was. Trying it on, if you ask me.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh, Greg. I came across a word in a book last night. Hemophobe.
What were you reading, a medical dictionary?
What does it mean?
Hemophobia, fear of blood.
But everyone's frightened of blood.
Not to the extent of fainting or vomiting at the sight of it. Most hemophobes manage to live with it, but it can be quite a handicap if you want to be a policeman or a doctor.
Sister officer, that counts. He can't lose his job for having hemophobia, though.
You have to expect a little nausea with pregnancy.
A little nausea?
Well, it should clear up in about 6 weeks, but I'll give you some more medicine if it's really bothering you.
Of course it is. Oh, there's something else you could do for me. Mm-hmm. My solicitor wants a letter stating I'm pregnant.
Is he going to use it in court?
Does he have to do a test
run? Yeah, I'm going to do the poor little mother bit.
Yes, well, you are pregnant. Oh. Take a teaspoonful of that every morning, first thing.
I didn't know you were engaged to Karen Travers.
That was a very long time ago.
Fancy throwing you over. I wouldn't have.
You'd have been fully 15 at the time.
But I'm a big girl now.
Yes, and you're going to get a great deal bigger. Tell me, have you given any thought to that baby's future?
You don't think I care, do you? Well, you're wrong. When I'm released, I'm going to get the very best antenatal care there is.
I'm glad to hear it.
Yes. You'll be seeing quite a lot of me.
You don't intend coming to me.
Why not? You're my doctor, aren't you? And now you've started your own practice.
Yes, but I'm a GP, not a gynecologist.
You'll suit me fine.
You got a damned hide coming here to see me.
I ain't done nothing.
Don't give me that. I know what you've been up to. What do you mean, you lazy little bitch, fronting up for the dole?
I needed it. Denny and me was going to use it for rent.
You and Denny?
To be fair, she was saving up before.
What about your own family?
I couldn't take it home to them. Gran wouldn't take doll money.
Of course she wouldn't. You ever see her trying for a pension?
You know, what's the difference of getting it from the state or stealing it from somebody else?
Bludgers.
You know, if you...
You call yourself
don't need
Burke.
It, that
You're
is.
Not a Burke's bootlace.
Miss Vernon said it was all right.
Oh, yeah, it's all right for a vermin. But you were born a Burke. We don't take charity. Not from the Salvos, not from the government, not from anybody. The Burkes don't take help. We help ourselves.
And yeah, it's basically charity stealing from other people. Without
anyway,
their permission.
Doesn't matter now. Denny shot through.
And good riddance.
We got kicked out of the flat too.
Serves you right.
All right, don't keep on. I'll go back and look after Gran and the kids.
Oh, I know you bloody well won't. Not while you're on the dole. They wouldn't have you in the house.
Well, what am I supposed to do? It's all right for you. You get fed in here. Huh. The government keeps you. Why can't they keep me?
Because I won't stand for it.
You either sign off that doll or I wash my hands of you, Leanne.
If you need help, people, claim social, claim dole, job seekers, whatever. Don't steal.
I gotta sign out. Leanne, hang on.
Don't take her to your office.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
You've spoken to your mother?
Of course I have. What do you think I'm doing here?
And what did she say?
She said I can't. She won't let me.
Hey, come on.
Was she still treating her nice when she stole
Look,
from them?
Let's go to my office and we'll talk about it there. Come on.
Let's talk about it there, please.
Now, what's all this about?
Stay that side.
Mum's crooked on you, all right? Yes, well, so I gather. But I also believe that she's crooked on you.
She says they're not going to let me home. The family's wiped me off.
Oh, she can't mean that.
You don't know me, Mum. It's all your fault. If I hadn't fronted up for the doll, she wouldn't have gone for me like that.
I'm sorry that I upset your mother, but you do need some sort of support.
My doll check hasn't come through yet either.
Yes, well, I'll see what I can do about that.
Oh, don't you do anything. You'll only get me into more trouble.
The question is, what are you going to do about it?
I don't know.
Have you got any money?
You gotta be kidding.
Well, what about a bed for tonight?
Is she going to invite her back
Denny
to Meg's?
Denny was thrown out of the flat.
Can't Denny help you?
He shot through.
Leanne, will you wait here? I have an idea.
No, right. They don't. Steal that picture, please. Take it as a souvenir.
I don't
mind burning it one last time if she nicks it.
No.
Little girl, wasn't it?
Yeah, about 5 years old.
How'd she do it?
Dunno.
Well, what did she do it for? Was she off a scone or something?
No. Her boyfriend was cooling off because of the kid. Having second thoughts about marrying her. So she knocks the kid off so she can marry the crummy bastard. What an animal!
Kids before blokes, please. Your kids. Not just any kids.
Oh, there's plenty of time. Plenty of time.
Bashing's too good for her. I reckon we ought to do something real heavy.
To wait until the screws ease off, they're watching her like she was Princess Anne.
I'll have a go.
Don't be stupid, Monty. You only got 2 months to go. Get a whole lot longer if you're caught roughing her up.
I've got nothing to get out of here for. Friends inside. Cops have got me a little nest egg by now. Might as well have a little bit of fun while I'm here.
You're mad, Monty.
This fresh air, it really does something for you. Enjoying yourself, Monica? Yep. But not nearly as much as I'm going to.
Stop her. Meg. You know... Should have stopped him before it even happened. Oh, she's there.
You're mad, Monty.
I thought she'd rather be out.
Like a ton of bricks.
You keep the screws busy.
Oh, don't be stupid. They're not that green.
I'll be quick.
Big M might be quicker.
I'm not worried about old fat guts. Now, are you going to cover for
Pot
me?
Pot kettle. Again.
Oh, all right, but you're as mad as a snake. You'll never get away with it.
Shout that. That's okay.
I hear you don't like kids, Bella, baby.
You push off.
Little girls about that big, I hear you got a down on. Little nippers who can't fight back.
You leave her alone.
Oh, rack off, fatso. Leave her alone. Get off me. Bloody
ass. I still think Martha... He's setting her up. Just get close to her.
You're never gonna help me!
What do you think you're doing?
She almost killed me!
She jumped before I had a chance to open my mouth.
Well, you can tell that to Mrs. Davidson. Now move it!
Move along there.
Your mate's not quite ready for the big event, is she? Not when she can be flattened by the Incredible Hulk. Fancy being beaten by Big M.
Problem now, though.
You better watch it, B. She'll be taking you on next.
That'll be the day.
She's still out there. And the screws have gone in.
What you're going to do to the Albrecht, Dame. I'd like to see you get near her now.
Would you? Then stay tuned. You might just see that. And sooner than you think.
And I turned to find both prisoners struggling on the ground.
You didn't see Ferguson attack Albrecht.
She'd have choked me if Martha hadn't stepped in. I'm going to have marks on my neck for weeks.
I'm afraid we'll have to make an example of you, Ferguson.
What for? Every woman in here would do the same thing if I had the chance.
Then we'll just have to make sure they don't get the chance, won't we? Take it as solitary for the night.
The night, really? They're going to transfer her.
We had to expect something like this, and they may try again. Your presence in here is a great nuisance to everyone. Try to stay out of trouble, both of you. You may go.
Martha's going to have to get into trouble in order to protect her. She should be given a bit of leeway.
Well, I can't spare any more staff to guard her.
Well, while she's got Martha Eves tagging along behind her, she seems safe enough.
You think she is genuinely concerned about Albrecht?
If, by the way, she was thumping Ferguson as any indication.
Well, it would ease the staff situation if Eves could be trusted. Still, we can't expose Albrecht unnecessarily. Mrs. Jackson, see that she takes her shower later than the other women. Mr. Fletcher,
make sure
she's kept away from all the others except Martha.
Right.
Yes, Governor.
That is all.
Don't think Martha's going to kill her.
Damn sight easier if we kept Albrecht locked in a cell the whole time.
Oh, come on, we're not in the chain gang business.
Yeah, more's a pity.
They're women, Jim.
You mean the gentler sex.
Meg, I've been looking for you everywhere.
Good morning.
I've been talking to Leanne Berg.
Oh, did she admit to the burglary?
No, but could she sleep over?
I was conscious in the girl herself. Meg, we've got to help her.
We?
Well, she's got no job, no prospects, and no home.
What about her family?
They threw her out because I made her apply for the doll.
Oh, she'll come up, Roses. That sort always do.
Meg, I wanted to stay with us for a few days.
You want what?
Oh, they threw her without their family around.
Do you know what you're
Meg,
asking?
Meg, it's only for a few days until I can get her on her feet and find her a job.
She'll rob us blind.
I'll make sure that she doesn't. Look, she's only 16.
Oh, all right.
Meg.
She's got to be out by Friday.
What bloody soft touch. She's not going to learn until she's hurt.
Leanne, there is an ashtray.
Yeah, well, you didn't say not to.
That's all right.
What were the smoking age in Australia in 1979?
I'll go then. You have nowhere to go, have you? How would you like to come to my place? We could put you up for a few days.
Who's we?
One of the prison officers here. I've asked her and she's agreed to it.
No, Lean's going to love this.
Suppose I'd have to do all the housework and stuff.
No, you'd be my guest for a few days until I find you somewhere else. And that shouldn't take long, with the doll coming through.
Yeah, that'd be real beaut. I haven't stayed in a flat like that before.
A flat like what?
Wall to wall.
And when were you inside it?
Who said I'd been inside? Just passed by outside. Said to me friend, that's where Miss Vernon lives. And he said, yep, looks as if it'd have wall to wall.
Leanne, if we're going to get along, you mustn't lie to me. Now, I'll be honest with you, and you must be honest with me. I know that you took that $20 and the transistor radio.
Yeah, and you just try back. And prove
it. I don't want to prove it. It doesn't matter. What does matter is that you get your feet on the ground and a good job. Okay?
Sure, Miss Vernon. All right.
Yes, I've got the medical report from your doctor here.
It's not going to go well.
Very. Frail, abandoned little mother. Won't be a dry eye in the house.
Great. How's my father? Still...
No. Time the great healer's been at work. He's agreed to be a character witness.
My stepmother must have got to him. He wouldn't do it without a push. Is he going to pay my bail?
Hardly any need for that. You should be free tomorrow.
God, I hope you're right.
Melinda, you're young, you're pretty, you're pregnant. And you were out of your mind with grief when you committed the offence. Tom Burton was an infamous womaniser that any right-thinking magistrate would abhor.
Can you imagine if she's not pregnant?
Especially a lay preacher like old Willoughby. You're home and hosed, my dear.
But he never did a test. He's just going off her morning sickness.
Give us a hand.
I'll have five.
Not bashing the books tonight.
What's the point?
I thought that university was a pretty big deal with you.
It's a big deal if Wentworth's all you got. Now I'm getting out of here, I'm wondering why I bothered.
Well, well, look who's here. Bella, the baby butcher.
Give it a rest, Bea. Don't you ever get tired of stirring?
What should I do, give her a round of applause?
There's enough misery in here without you making more trouble.
She killed her innocent kid, didn't she?
Well, if you're setting yourself up as judge and jury, why stop with her? What about me? You know about me? I killed my baby. What's up with her?
Parole nerves. I've seen it before.
Did she kill her own child?
Of course she didn't. She had an abortion because her old man didn't want kids.
But I'm going to guess if she is pregnant, so that's what she's going to do as soon as she gets out.
Nothing in this hand. Who's dealing?
I am.
Are you all right?
Is she walking out alone with that Martha?
Perfectly. They don't understand, do they? Well, how can they, the stupid great animals?
Understand what?
Is there more to why she killed her?
You love someone so much that you'd do anything to keep him? It's how you loved your husband, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's how I loved him.
They all go on about the kids. Robert would have married me long ago if it hadn't been for that child.
No. There isn't more to it.
He loved me, you know. Look what he gave me.
Oh, it's a beautiful ring.
He adored me. But you can't expect him to take on another man's child.
Look, I'm sorry, I don't want to talk about it.
I can understand why you're upset. The women here are enough to upset anyone. Oh, look, I'm so glad you're here.
Could you say something bad about Martha?
It's a joy to meet a real human being. I've been desperate for intelligent company. Up until now, I've been stuck with Martha. Oh, she's all right to keep the heavies at bay, but you'd get more sense from an orangutan.
Goodbye, Bella.
Morning, Meg. Sleep well?
Not particularly.
How'd you sleep, Leanne?
Have you got any jam?
We have marmalade here for breakfast.
We have jam.
Don't worry, I'll get it. You're running late.
That's because I had to clean up the bathroom. It was a swamp.
Leanne, didn't you clean up after you?
You said I wasn't to do any housework.
Oh, no.
Well, yeah, I mean, clean the bath out after yourself. I'll shower.
And what are you and Miss Burke going to do today?
I'm going to find Leanne a job.
Best of British.
Well, I'll speak to my friend about it anyway.
And how is Miss Burke going to occupy herself?
She is going to the Methodist Church.
I'm a Catholic.
You're not going there to worship. They run a workshop for the young unemployed. There'll be plenty of kids your own age there.
Boys?
And girls. You'll enjoy yourself.
Yeah. That'll be real beaut.
Yes,
she's going to take liberties.
Hey, it's not that late. What old job?
We have a guest in the house. You've heard of Attila the Hun. Well, this is his sister, Tilly. Well,
why'd you take her in then?
I didn't. Jean did. She's one of her waifs and strays.
Oh, if she's some poor kid that needs a helping hand, you ought to be a bit more tolerant.
This is Nolene Burke's daughter.
Is she like her mother?
Worse.
Yeah, well, I see what you mean then.
I was a fool to even consider having the girl in the flat.
You're too soft-hearted, Meg. Huh.
Soft-headed, you mean? Oh, well, we all have our little weaknesses, I suppose.
What do you mean by that?
He's getting very paranoid about this.
Weakness? Has Vera been talking to you?
No, Vera hasn't been talking to me. Honestly, Jim, I don't know what you're on about.
Yeah, forget it. It doesn't matter.
What a breakfast.
Wouldn't it make suspicions,
Jim? That slop porridge.
Better when it's sloppy, it hasn't got as many lumps.
Speaking of lumps... Well, here comes a great brain. The stroke of genius belting Bella in front of the screws. Got any more bad ideas? Or are you getting fond of the pound?
Well, it was worth it. Scared the bejesus out of her.
Oh, yeah, giant step for mankind.
Well, it was good for a laugh, anyway. And there she is, trying to strangle Bella, and Evesy charges her like a wounded bull. She's down on top of her like a ton of bricks, and Monty's trying to pull her hair, and she can't reach, and I look like ringside with her. You had to be there.
Sorry about the bed,
Bea. Yeah.
Yeah, well, it'll be different next time.
Oh, you're pathetic, the lot of you, don't you?
Yeah, well, duh. Oh, forget her. Oh, they shan't be out of the showers this morning. Didn't even get one.
Sure.
They want to leave it all clear for the baby butcher.
Are they allowed to do that?
Governor's orders. They don't want to get in any hot water.
Is that a nighttime shower?
Hey, get a bait in the hot water?
Yeah, I got it, Monty. You were a laugh a minute.
Yeah, well, Madame Davidson doesn't want to get accidentally scolded, like some people I could mention.
She does something to the shower.
Will you two shut up and let me think?
Now, she's going to be in the shower block while we're in the laundry.
Hmm. Yeah, her and Big M.
You have to worry about Big M. You haven't know how to handle her. Trouble with you, Molly, is you don't know how to handle her.
Oh, and I suppose you could.
I've always told you, Molly, you've got to pick your time. Now, all I'm going to do is figure out a way of getting in to the shower block from the laundry.
No, Lena had a smile on her face like she knew.
Where have you been? You're supposed to be with me all the time.
I don't have to.
But we're friends, Martha, aren't we? Good friends. I mean, you hardly spoke to me at breakfast. What have I done wrong?
I didn't think you liked me talking.
But of course I do. I'm interested in everything you say.
You think I'm stupid?
No, I don't. I mean, you saved my life. I can't think of anything cleverer than that.
Yeah. Monty would have done for you if I hadn't stepped in. She'll probably have another go. She or someone else.
I know.
I've been doing some thinking. It's not that I can't think good, Bella. It's just that I can't put it into words.
Yes, I thought it was something like that.
You're not safe in here. Someone's always going to have a go at you in here. So you've got to get out, see? Both of us will get out, and then you can take me and show me where you keep your pony.
Pony?
Yeah, you know, the one that eats the roses by the tennis court.
That was years
ago. I never had a pony.
Yes, of course you can see the pony. If you get me out of here.
Oh, that's easy. I've got it all figured out.
Time for your shower, Albrecht. You go with her, Eves.
And where are the other women?
They're all at work. You'll be safe enough.
Eves is playing a game. Maybe I was wrong about her not... I mean, lulling them into a false sense of security before, but after
well,
she heard that...
how are you going to get me out of here?
Shh!
Oh, she can't hear out there.
It's all right, she's gone now.
Well, what's the plan?
Well... we pretend we're working in the garden, see? The screws won't be watching us in the garden because they'll be too busy watching the others.
Well, they can't ignore us completely. And I hope this isn't about vaulting over the fence in full view of the guard.
This is better. And I know it'll work because I saw it in a film.
Tunnel away out?
In a film. I suppose we hire a helicopter.
No fear. You wouldn't catch me in one of those things.
Well, what is this plan that you saw in a film?
Well... these blokes in the film, they was in the army. But they were in prison too. They get up close to the
great
fence
escape
with this wooden oars. And then they start digging a tunnel.
I don't believe this.
We could do it. All we need is something to hide us from the screws while we start to dig, see?
Oh, God. I just don't believe it. I mean, I thought you could get me out. I must be as stupid as you are.
Oof.
I'm not stupid.
Oh, you cretinous. You're a great big blundering nitwitted vegetable. You're a fat fool, and I thought you could get me out.
You can look after yourself then.
Oh, well, if I can't do better than the village idiot. Anyway, they're keeping all the women away from me now, so I don't need you.
Goodbye, Bella.
You were going to show me the pony.
Pony's been dead for years.
Quick, people, before she goes too far. Martha? Well, it's not that dark. Oh. She only told Martha about that though, didn't she? She's gonna drown her. Well, that was bloody quick. She didn't even really hold her breath. She just breathed out the entire time and then died. You know, no 1 or 2 minutes of holding your breath before passing out and then dying. I still think it was Martha. I do. I don't think it was B or Moni, but is B going to get blamed for this and get transferred? I don't think... Could Nolene have done it? No. She's got it all here with mouth. She hasn't got it all with action. I don't think it'd be Nolene. Definitely not Karen. Definitely not Lizzie. There's so many suspects, but there's so many you can get rid of as well. Vera. She's murdered before. She can murder again. Well, this one didn't last long. Not long at all. We need a replacement, please. I mean, Burke's getting out soon. Moni's getting out soon. Karen's getting out soon. Bloody hell, everyone's getting out soon. Gonna be no show left, sign out. The longer I was in there, the longer I would have been stringing Martha along, pretending I was a friend. You know, I would have always had those suspicions as well. Are these doing it just to, you know, lull me into a false sense of security or something like that? I'd be no good in prison, I can promise you that. I'd be in solitary every single day. As soon as I get out, trash the governor's office or something, back in. I'd be in prison for life and I'd never be out of solitary. I'm telling you. We knew she weren't going to last long. I did think, you know, there may have been something more to it. The kid could have been gravely ill or something like that. But she literally admitted, nope, she just wanted to get married and the kid was in the way. I hate people like that. There's so many women out there, and men, people who want to be fathers, who cannot have babies and they would love to and they'd probably be the best parents in the world. And then you get people like that. And unfortunately, those people do exist in our world. Thankfully, few, but they still exist. If there is a God, he picks the wrong people to not allow babies. But anyway, enough about that. That's just my little rant there. Still enjoying this show. I hope you're glad it's gone twice weekly. And if you are, and you haven't subscribed to me or followed on Dailymotion so far, could I please ask you to do so? It would really help me out. Australians could only see this on Dailymotion, I'm afraid. It did get blocked on YouTube for you. But a lot of shows do go up earlier on Dailymotion. Not always the YouTube shows, they can sometimes go up later, but the shows that you get the Now on Dailymotion video for do get up earlier because it doesn't have this scheduled time to go live thing that YouTube does. If you have already, thank you ever so much. I really do appreciate it. I honestly do. You're helping me out, you're helping the channel out, you're helping my mental health out. You honestly are. I have changed my bio now on YouTube. Because I am sick of people having a go at me for doing this, reacting to shows. I started this challenge. You will get a full video of this if I get enough subscribers. I don't like talking about it. It does set my anxieties off. But I did this channel in order to help me with my mental health issues. I've got quite a few. I've got physical issues as well. But obviously, it doesn't help with the physical. But it does help a little with the mental health, temporarily, not completely. And I started the channel for that. I didn't think people would like me. I was just doing it for me. People enjoyed the content. And it gave me a sense of responsibility. Something I've not had in a long time. It is really helping me out. It honestly is. And when I say about helping my mental health, I truly do mean it. So the bio's been changed because I'm getting sick of the amount of people who are having a go at me for doing reaction channels without knowing the full facts. I've had people who have told the full facts and they have understood. I mean, I can understand them not being 100% believers in what I say, because I get quite a few liars out there, like the man in the wheelchair, the streamer who just got up out of the wheelchair, even though he's supposed to be paralysed. They do throw shade on people who tell the truth. And I promise you, I don't want to lie to my audience. I want to be 100% truthful to my audience in everything I do. And I'm going to stop talking about it now because I can feel it getting to me. But yes, I am honest when I say I've got it. So people, please, if you're going to throw hate at me, look at my bio first in the description in the channel bio thing. But if you're a Patreon member, we'll get exclusive shows, which will be on the screen right now. 8 per month right now, going up to 12 per month very shortly. I'm working on the extra day as we speak. I'm sorry I've gone a bit down in tone now. Like I say, talking about that really does affect me. But yes, I get 8 per month right now, going up to 12 per month later this year. I am working on the third day as we speak. That will be American Horror Story, The X-Files, Roseanne and Cheers. And then there'll be a fourth day coming later this year or early next year. There'll be drama shows like Dallas, Dynasty, Band of Gold, Footballers' Wives, Teachers, Cold Feet, Quantum Leap, things like that. That's what'll come on those days. And then there'll be two Patreon Choice days, or Buy Me a Coffee Choice. Buy Me a Coffee commissions. If you commission a show on Buy Me a Coffee, it will get put straight to the top. It won't wait around until, you know, if I'm doing an editing session, I will cut that editing session short to buy that DVD and react to it as soon as I get it. Then I'll go back to editing once I've done that, but I'll edit that first. So if you commission shows, you will get them as soon as I can possibly get them to you without waiting for scheduling or me recording again or anything like that. They also get access to ad-free and uncensored shows as well. So no bleeps, no blurs, nothing like that. Completely ad-free and uncensored, unless the shows do it themselves. Because it is you that is bringing the content to me, to allow me to bring the content straight back to you. Thank you all ever so much. I love you lots, no matter what tier you are. So with that, I shall sign out now and move on to the next one, and I hope to see you there. Goodbye.